home of Kathleen Moore that she resided in with her boyfriend or fiance or whoever he was. Right there. Looks like he owns this. This gentleman has been arrested multiple times for domestic violence as well as drug-related crimes. So there's his lawn maintenance. See if they'll be willing to talk at all. Looks like he might have left, but he's up here knocking on his door anyways. There are definitely dogs inside. Camera up there. So the gentleman, you can hear the dogs inside. I heard some movement moving around inside, so he's definitely here. Hi, ma'am. My name is Andra. I'm with the U.S. Press Corps. You obviously lived across the street here. I know this has got to be hard, you being a woman and everything, but the. You have no idea. Did they ever fight? Did you ever know if they fought or anything like that?
I didn't see her there like every day, but
right.
They were quiet.
Yeah, because we heard that they had an altercation and she got in an Uber. You didn't by chance, you know, the Sunday after Thanksgiving see like an Uber or any cars or any activity over here? No. Okay, I appreciate your time. Thanks so much. She's missing, presumed dead. They found her cell phone. The last person that saw her was her boyfriend, Collin. He's got a huge rap sheet of domestic violence convictions as well as drug convictions. And yeah, and so, you know, it's... I believe he is. I just knocked on the door and I heard the dogs and I heard some shuffling around inside. I will tell you, unfortunately, and it kind of sucks that you're the neighbor, but I have a funny feeling there's going to be a protest here tomorrow. In front of this house demanding answers. So, you know, we're just, I'm trying to find out if he's willing to talk, if we can, you know, get some information, but she's been gone for weeks. Nobody's seen or heard from her, her family, nothing. And with his domestic violence convictions and his drug convictions and her stuff now finding its way locally in dumpsters and things of that nature, we believe there's foul play involved. So, just thought I'd prepare you with it. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.
Uh-huh. What's this? Next door neighbor has a chair out front that says, "Don't bother, don't ring the doorbell. Or knock, you are trespassing, thank you." So that's what that sign says, the neighbor of 7143. So we will not be bothering them. Let's see what happens over here at 7140. There's also a sign over here, 7140. 7140 says, All news reporters, don't bother. Do not ring the doorbell or knock. You are trespassing. So a couple of the neighbors are already not wanting any intrusion, knocking, or anything of that nature. They're going to be unfortunately surprised when we start bringing the bullhorns out. This car that's coming by right now is from the neighbor's house. Again, from the neighbor's house that did not like. They got two cars. That was the one. Another car came out of the neighbor's house. We're going to be going up there very soon. I've been out here for a little bit monitoring the house. I'm going to be, it's light enough that I think I'm going to be walking down so I can get pictures of the vehicles in front of the house. So it's light enough right now for me to feel safe walking. I've been sitting in my car since like 5:20 with boots on the grounds here related to Kathleen Moore's case and Collin Knapp. He is presumed to have some culpability in her disappearance. So I'm just going to be walking up here and getting but a couple neighbors have left. A police officer actually drove by very slowly, so we're just going to walk down here. I'm just going to get some pictures of the front of the house, and we'll go from there. Kathleen Moore disappeared November 28th. Late into the morning of November 29th, several items have showed up in dumpsters in and around this area, this particular community, and why their focus is on Collin Knapp. Yesterday we were here, knocked the door, nobody answered. There was only a truck and a trailer here. As you can see, there's much more vehicles in their driveway. It's presumed to be Escobar, Angie, and Collin have now come home. There it is. So we're gonna get this. That's the neighbor that has the sign up, the no trespassing. Sorry guys, I'm gonna twist you guys over just a little bit. Sorry, I'm taking some photos. They are all home. Collin Knapp's home. They are all home. So right now we are behind, let me see if I can read. We're behind, for those people that want to tag this, it's on a magnet. I'm driving hands-free. I'm driving hands-free, so not doing anything dangerous, but we are stopping. I want to get his license plate in this video. We are stopping at a wooded area behind Collin Knapp's home. So right now, we are behind Collin Knapp's home. Right there. There's this big, swampy forest back here. We're back here now. But this is definitely a place I would think law enforcement would like to start focusing some efforts in the search for Kathleen Moore. I can tell you there's briars out here. It's hard to get back here. There's a lot of swamp. But this is a great place to hide somebody that you don't want found. Great place to hide somebody that you don't want found. So I hope if law enforcement hasn't already, that they will find a way to get back here and search this area very well. I mean, there's just a lot of trees. I mean, this stuff is pretty thick. I mean, you can see my foot. It sinks down. It comes up almost to my knees. We're walking back here trying to find any evidence of where Kathleen Moore may be. Again, lots of places back here. You can see that somebody sets up here and plays back here. We're going to keep looking through here in the areas that we can look through by foot. There's just some areas we can't get to without having some water boots or other modifications and provisions to get to. But our thought is they would have had to have found something close by, because we've seen, ouch, maybe I shouldn't have touched that, but I found this. I don't think it is anything, but you never know. I don't see any blood or anything on it, but it is something. Yeah, Olivia's mom would find a mess of stuff out here. That woman is amazing. Let's see what we can find out here. So you can see, I don't know if necessarily this would be the place, because people can see commotion going on out here. But people play out here, obviously. Things do go on out here. You know. And then there's a break in the fence. Cobwebs. I got mosquitoes. I got spiders. I got God knows what else. I hope I don't terrify these neighbors going through here. It's not my intention. My intention is to find Kathleen. And it doesn't look like I'm going to from here. I don't see any disturbance. I don't smell anything funky. I don't see. Oh, jeez. I tell you, this is tough. I don't see any disturbed dirt where I can see by the eye, but there is a big swamp type lake area, you know, back here, and you know, she could be fully submerged. I also want to look at other lakes and other wooded areas in this vicinity. This can't be the only one. We just need to figure out what they did. Lighters. So people come back here. People coming back here is no big deal.
because there's a lot of stuff out here showing us that people come back here regularly. I see some people back here. Maybe it was maybe some kids come out here to play. It's definitely this is back here where you can. Bet my knee back. Oh. I do not like spider webs. I do not like spider webs at all. Oh, that yoked my knee. That's okay. That's okay. Alright, let's see how it. See these things, they have thorns on them. Big old thorns. It's a big old vine, so I've got to be careful because this stuff can tear you up. And it looks like it's going to tear me up. Let me just get it down. It's already grown up in the tree. This stuff sucks. Wish I knew I was going to go in here. I would have wore freaking shoes appropriate and jeans. I'm getting my legs all torn up. It makes the searching difficult when you're not prepared with the right proper clothing to go back here because all these briars have all these thorns and stuff all over them that just they burn when they break skin. But it's not going to stop us. It's not going to stop us. We're going to keep looking until we find her. Kathleen's family deserves answers. They just deserve answers. Means I'm gonna get my legs scratched up. By God, that's what it's gonna be. They'd be this far back because you got houses right there. You would want it to be as quiet as possible. I mean, it's not going to ever be quiet because you got several people scared out of their mind trying to dump a body. So, this whole area in particular. Somebody's kept old.
I'm just right here.
I'm gonna try to see if I...
One vehicle is missing, the Chevy Traverse. Okay, then I'll move my vehicle too. But the Chevy Traverse has taken off. Chevy Traverse has taken off. Where's Kathleen, Collin? We will be out here protesting. We're bringing people with us. We want to know where Kathleen is. We do have a right to be here. So I'm asking, you guys know something. And why are they finding stuff around this area? Yeah, but he hasn't come out. He hasn't asked for the public's help to clear his name. Nothing.
Call him. Public street.
We want to
call him.
Yeah. There's nothing they can do. Thank you. We know the law. Thank you. See this? See this? This allows us to do this.
Okay.
So are we. And so are we. And so are we.
So we're
good. Okay, good.
What does Collin have to say to her family?
You don't worry about a woman being just gone?
She's not fucking here. She's not here.
You're right. She's probably dead.
I have no idea why she's not fucking here.
This has nothing to do with you.
It has nothing to do with you.
Where's Kathy? Well, you see Kathy? How do you know it has nothing to do with them? How do you know? What do you know?
Yeah, what do you know?
What do you know? What do you know, Collin? What do you know?
Well, the Escobar gentleman. Yeah, he talked. He seemed sincere. Yeah, he's.
Oh, that was him by the door?
Yeah.
Collin was the guy with the beard.
Yeah, he's the guy with the beard.
I don't know these people. Okay. The police will be out, but that's good.
Yeah, it's fine. Call the police. I want to know where Angie went.
Now, does he live here?
Yes.
He does live here. With him?
Yes, he lives here. So it's a parking issue.
That's partly the issue. Did you all enter onto his property? We're being advised that you did step onto his property.
No, we got it recorded. We were out here on the road.
That's what I'm being advised. That's what I'm being advised. I'll double check it. There are cameras.
Nobody stepped onto his property. So if someone made a report saying this, would they be charged with a false report?
Not as far as possible.
I mean, if no one stepped on the property. I didn't step on anyone's property.
Possibly.
So that would be a false report.
Possibly, depending on how that information is portrayed.
So we came back to the law enforcement. Obviously, there's a girl missing.
Yes.
I know her family person.
Okay.
We are going to protest.
Okay.
We're going to peacefully protest, stay on the street and protest. We have that right, correct?
Yes, you do have the right to protest. However, we cannot block thoroughfares.
Okay,
there is
so
no
cars.
The cars cannot be parked. There is no parking in Pasco County roadways. Okay, this is a public road that's maintained by Pasco. There is no parking in this area. So that's as far as you take the move. To move off the roadways, we're not blocking. If you're not going to protest, then it's fine. You have the right to protest as long as you're not blocking any roadways.
Or stepping on properties.
And stepping on properties, that kind of stuff. However, again, want to watch as far as we have not infringing anyone's civil rights and stuff too, as far as harassment kind of things. I don't know if there was any contact of made or whatnot. All I know is there's information, a call came in from us. We're having people outside someone's home. We're coming to respond, check on that, talk to everybody, and go from there.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what we're here as far as on that, just to double check. Everybody does have the right to protest, we understand that. But we do have to look at all parties. There's an active investigation, I understand that. Yes, there's a missing person. But don't understand that. I cannot sit here and comment on any of that investigation that's going on. My job is patrol. Our investigators are conducting an investigation. That's all I can tell you as far as on. You can reach out to a public information officer, be able to provide you with any further information that you need as far as on that, where the status of that is. Yeah, I cannot comment as far as the issue as far as someone saying there's cars outside their property in the roadway and people possibly coming out of the road.
And there is a public easement on these properties, correct? That we can safely walk to protest?
Yeah, people, the properties are maintained by the homeowners.
None of us,
so
I can assure you, none of us stepped on these properties.
Again, so listen, there's an active investigation. Trust me, if there's anything that has to go, I have full confidence as far as my colleagues that are doing that. Trust that you would have us and let us do our investigation. I understand people want to protest, but sometimes protesting, either everybody has very strong feelings about it, you're saying you're personally involved in it, and I understand that. Sometimes that can have an adverse effect. Sometimes a very positive effect.
Someone
I understand that.
You know,
I understand that. But
sick, can't sleep,
again,
nightmares.
There is, everyone is presumed innocent or proven guilty. You see that from basic high school grade books and constitution or constitutional rights and like that before presuming something. So we have to give everyone the benefit of the doubt until let our investigations go forward, let our investigators do what they gotta do, and try not to possibly hamper anything.
Yeah.
We don't want to do this. So there's active investigation. If it determines one way or another, whatever it may be, trust me, we're gonna follow it.
You want us to move our cars?
I would like as far as move them off the roadway, yes, if you can, so as far as we're not violating
comply,
the laws and we're not.
We don't want to break the law. Yet. That's the thing. We want to be full compliance of the law.
And
yeah.
I appreciate that. And I appreciate that. But again, at the same time, we don't want a lawyer and all that kind of stuff. I mean, there's nothing going on here right now.
Well, it sounds like we have the right to protest, but you don't want us to have the right to protest, and that you're finding some loopholes in our constitutional rights to protest.
I'm asking for cooperation and let our detectives and our investigators do their job with the active investigation. And that's what I'm asking for.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I'm saying is, what you're trying
you're
to
have
do,
media
to have media.
I'm going to let you guys know. This case is getting out.
Yeah, because we're going to...
Completely understand.
And that's why
we're
going to...
And
we're going to keep communicating if we see them.
But again, you got to let us do an investigation. Sometimes...
But there's more of us than you. You know what I'm saying?
I understand that.
We can help you.
Okay.
Without being law enforcement.
But...
so listen. Well, I'm just here to die.
You guys can, as far as... I would say same thing. Look up our bolos. You're gonna make the determination as far as how you think sitting out here in front of the house is helpful. I'm not asking a question. I'm saying that's on you to sit there and think about that. Again, I have my investigators, my detectives that are doing the investigation. I'll let them do their investigation. I'm gonna handle what I have to handle. I'm a patrol sergeant. I'm out here on the road. This is what I do.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you
very
much.
Yeah, we have no intention of breaking in.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you.
mask earlier and back it out.
Hey, John, tell them about this guy.
Well, this guy here is kind of irate, too.
Well, it seems like there's a little seedy element that's going on right in this little general area. So where would you like to go? You want to go up to the McDonald's? Okay. Operation Make Someone Feel Uncomfortable has started. Well, you know what? That's what we thought too with Brian Laundry, and we were out there searching, expecting to see the birds and the, you know, the insects, and we couldn't find any of that. We couldn't find the vultures. You know, okay. There was nothing. And by the time, you know, yeah, he was bones.
In my opinion, I think she's close.
I think she can't get too far.
Can't be too far.
I got chills. Bone got dumped up there.
They're mafia.
And land in between.
They deboned them. That's what I think.
Yeah, no, we found out that within that climate and everything, we found out that a body can decompose in 10 days, and that heat that we were dealing with there, 10 days to bones. And I'm telling you, when we found it, we did, when we were out there with Mike Rua's fox.
So you think he committed, it was a gunshot wound to the head, right?
Yeah, we knew it was a gun related, because when we were on, boots on the ground, we heard them as soon as, like within 5 or so minutes after they said they found his remains, we heard them say, we found the gun.
The river floods to that street, and sometimes it floods to this house right here.
So it just gets,
if it rains a lot, the river rises right there.
So their mind, his mind, is just get washed away eventually. I don't just think he's thinking.
He was just trying to get rid of her.
Yeah, he's not. He don't look the smartest.
He doesn't look sophisticated, planned, or anything. It's
no.
Heat of the moment.
No.
Bam.
Well, you have to think that he's probably uneducated, which has an element to that, because he's been in and out of jail so much. And I find that people that go to jail in and out, that it's a revolving door, it lacks education. It's statistically true as well. So it's not like I'm just picking on people that go. I mean, there are a lot of smart people that go back and forth to jail, and especially having the drug and alcohol element in the mix. It just, you know.
Family members sent me a video. Friends of the family sent me a video of him that night dancing in a bar with all of them, and he looked happy just like 3 hours before he came home.
Yeah.
Really?
On that Saturday or that Sunday, 28th into the 29th.
Mm-hmm.
So
he was intoxicated, would you say?
I looked like in that video that he was stumbling around, just kind of geeked up. Kind of just like, you know, alcohol, you know, added
so this
some
is
drugs
the way to them?
Go berserk.
Oh, this is one of them?
This is the road we took, John.
We took that road.
That's the one she just pointed down. We already went down there. We went around, we went in the swamp and everything.
That's all it.
Oh, we went further down. We went much further down. Much further down. Let's just follow her. I'm going to follow her. Might as well. We're gonna do it. Let's do it.
It's all public, right?
This, yeah.
You know what? We should, because these mobile homes are thinner. They might have heard something scuffling around at night. Maybe we should.
All right, so this is the Nantua River.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then.
Right. Oh, we're going to go down.
You want to go down that way?
Yep.
You know what, Jonathan, though? Over there, I actually saw an upside-down boat that we might want to just lift.
You saw an upside-down boat?
Yeah, I did. I didn't think anything of it, but it just popped into my head. All right, so what we need to probably do at this point is we need to find some friends of Collin Knapp and find out where he liked to camp, where he liked to hang out. You know, we need to start tracing his steps to find out where he was and where he's been the last few days after the disappearance of Kathleen. We're going to have to locate and find out what he was up to. Huh. What is this? Hello? Hello? I didn't check to see if there was any. Well, that's it. Cross. Just cross on the. Yeah.
How do you know what's over here?
Yeah. It looks like somebody. I wanted to see if anybody was. Who it was, you know, if anybody was actually home. And nobody's here, but it's somebody was here, and it looks fresh, very fresh. Oh shit! All these things all over me. Like really fresh. But just because her friend, she called an Uber while she was on the phone with her friends, but doesn't mean the situation didn't get bad enough where she just took off. Where she just said, screw this, I'm out.
I will show them some of this property here and get home.
Yeah.
Only because...
Really?
Huh?
Really?
Only because... I hire them sometimes, and yeah. That's what they do.
Yeah.
They're the worst. They're the worst people to hire. Because they're drug addicts.
Yeah.
That's why.
But it makes me wonder, you know, could something else have happened to her besides Collin Knapp? It's giving a different kind of... So I just made an assessment. You know, we were with a neighbor. She kind of took us around, showed us the areas that were wooded. We're thinking that Kathleen's got to be close by, that these guys are not sophisticated enough to dispose of her body. They are probably jacked up, drunk, you know, just needing to get her out of the house, and they would go to a place of comfort. So we had her give us a ride. I just want to show you something. So look at how nice and manicured these houses are. These are people, hardworking men and women that take care and have pride of ownership. Pride of ownership is on this part right here. You got nice houses, well-manicured lawns, people that have nice things right here. And then you start walking down here. And while these houses are okay, that one and that one, it's presumed that they're owned by the same person. The gentleman that lives there lives with his parents. He looks like he is on drugs. But there's just a seedy element that goes along with these several houses that are abutting and near Collin's house. you can just see there's an element of disarray, no pride. You know, the roofs need to be redone. They're just, it's just a seedy, seedy element right here. It's like they all, you know, pass around their drugs to each other. And, you know, they all party together. And that's why they're so, like, even this lady here, she ended up leaving when we had law enforcement come. And it makes you wonder why. It makes you wonder why. Why is she leaving just because law enforcement shows up? So I have a funny feeling that this is a seedy few houses here that has a high presence of drug-related activity and alcoholism associated with them. And then after these four houses, or I should say five houses, you come here and the houses are nice again. The houses are manicured and look nice.
He went inside his house and then called the police.
Yeah.
He called the police. I'm asking him, dude, where's Kathleen?
I don't want to talk.
And then he used his roommate as a mouthpiece. His roommate, at least was semi sort of civil. So he hasn't seen her since Saturday. That's what he said. We've cooperated with authorities. I have cooperated. But, you know, who's he, the spokesman for Collin?
Right.
Is he the spokesman for Collin?
And I have a funny feeling it was Escobar that hadn't seen her since Sunday because clearly, I mean Saturday, because clearly she was at that house on FaceTime with her friends from Collin's house on Sunday
night.
Sunday night, early morning. Did they just do that?
Yep.
That's assault. Just want to let you know that.
Yep.
Did they on purpose?
Yep. They don't go off like that. I do irrigation.
Nice.
Yeah, it's and not only that, it's hooked up to a hose.
Yep, he turned the spigot. Yep.
That's kind of dumb.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Thank you. I was hot anyway.
I didn't even get wet. You got wet?
Yeah, I got a couple
it
drops.
Right it just...
So, yeah, so he's saying Saturday. So was he not in the house on Sunday with them? Or was he lying to us?
Right.
Question.
Right.
That's the question. So sorry for your loss, honey.
Thank you.
We really are.
What are you doing? And then she's out here. She found some stuff.
I have been out here since she's been missing. I got videos. I talked to the homeless man, Jonathan. I videoed them with the drones and the dogs out here, but nobody ever went over there. So my whole family went over there. We went from here all the way back through the swamp. Water's back there.
What about the back of his house?
I haven't made it to. I have not been on this property.
Behind his house was swamps. We were back there. We parked on Creek Road and we walked back there. But the problem is directly behind his house is swamp.
It's swamp. It's deep swamp.
We're told by a neighbor. We talked to her. Showed us around. Said she doesn't know the authorities were around her. No sir. So we're doing
what we can do. And I'm 100% sure it was her clothes yesterday. I literally found them over there.
Can you show us? Can we go?
Yeah, yes, please.
Thank you.
piece of crap. Person's missing and this person's acting like a complete jerk. So if you know him, yeah.
That's important here to try to figure out. Colin was not happy with us there, and that's why a reasonable person, an innocent person, would. Hey, help me find my friend.
Well, I mean, even with that, who cares? If a friend of yours is missing, whether you're getting death threats or not, that's no reason not to stop helping.
I have people calling me and texting me on my phone asking for money for her release, and they said not to tell that either.
Because I'm telling you, the roommate came out and talked to us, and he seemed sympathetic and empathetic and sincere. He did not.
We were going to walk down.
I'll wash her clothes. And they were wrong. She's not 180 pounds. She's 120 pounds. She's not 5'7". She's 5'11".
Yeah, this is... Law enforcement.
Is there anything left?
Is any of this hers?
No.
But it was right here.
Yeah. And I told Jeff, I thought maybe this white shirt was hers. Like maybe in that one black pair of panties looked really familiar, that I thought maybe that when she left bad, maybe she wrapped some of her stuff and threw it in the bag. Because she only came over here and stayed when she didn't have class for work. That's when she stayed.
And she wouldn't have any lace?
Let me ask you something. Is it possible someone else did it after she left there, or do you think he's involved?
Honestly, I don't even know, Colin. In 3 years that they've been on and off, she brought him home this year for Thanksgiving because Kathleen had a miscarriage.
She went to Colin's parents.
I was...
And the parents were not aware of Kathleen. They never had a
chance. And I told her about my husband. I don't think he feels the same way about her. And they actually left the road. Here, let me show you the road. Cops didn't even take it, but if you take and put your hands through it, I mean, you freaking tell me.
We're taking that.
This was over there.
Oh my God, I just got goosebumps. I just got goosebumps.
So here we got rope, we got underwear, garments.
I think this white shirt was her. It's a button down.
What in Sam's? I'm gonna take that.
You mind if she takes it?
No, I don't mind.
I mean, we're gonna.
I don't know why the cops didn't take it.
Yeah,
well, we.
If they have dogs, what the hell is the dog smelling? Because I'm telling you right now, they don't have something of Kathleen. I don't know who gave them something, but it couldn't have been Kathleen's, because I can't believe a dog couldn't find that.
Are you from here?
Actually, I live in Crescentville. I live on the water.
Holy shit. I think we need to call law enforcement out here and have them take all of this.
I don't know why they didn't take it all either, because I tried to call Collins yesterday to see
there
if...
There could be DNA on there.
To see if those were the clothes that she left with, and there was a pair of leggings.
right here. I don't think those were
hats. And then her phone was found right over there.
And her phone was found on the other side of the bridge in the dumpster.
Guys, it's a bag.
Ma'am, so what about... I'm sorry, what's your first name?
Diane.
I'm Andra.
And I'm sorry.
Diane, what about the land? What is that about?
They processed this scene. It's open. So this is, I mean, clearly this, why they didn't take that in is a little disturbing. Let me just.
I think we're pretty close.
I do too. I think we're getting closer.
I have a feeling we're getting closer.
We're getting closer. We're hot.
You been back here?
Look at that hypodermic needle.
A hypodermic needle.
Yeah, I think we should.
Why don't the police? It's just like any case. It's like they got better things to do. I don't understand it, man.
This is getting ridiculous. Law enforcement has to do better.
There's so many cold cases because they don't do their fucking job. I got a friend in homicide, retired up in New York. I should call Freddie to come down here.
It's empty.
It's empty?
It's empty. It's empty. It's empty. Well, not even that, but you've seen the well. There's, if you walk down there, you could carry a body down there, and there's that storm drain. That you can literally walk into.
Want to go in here?
Yeah.
Let's go in. Can you see them?
I got a flashlight on this phone.
My daughter did, but Walgreens really can't tell you anything either because the cops, just like they told us last night, not to be sharing the photos that I took of her clothes. They asked me to shut down my website of the surveillance with the drone, to shut down my websites with the homeless man I interviewed to find out exactly how he found her phone. And another key evidence is he found the phone in a Walgreens bag, and he specifically said you have to go in the store to get one of those bags.
Yes.
That's what it was in.
Pulse
in the dumpster. It was not just thrown in the dumpster. And he said on the front of it, you could tell that someone tried to break it because it had a big indentation. The screen wasn't cracked, but it was broken. He said, I didn't even think it would turn on. And it turned on. And it had 6%
light. People down there.
And he said it was weird because all of a sudden the phone rang in his hand.
They'll record them.
And it was the girlfriend of Pat calling to see where she was at, what, you know, what was going on.
What day was this? So Monday was the 29th.
Was the day that, I guess, what, Sunday when she left
him? It was 11/28, so it was... Yeah. When was the...
What was the homeless guy's name?
I'm really not supposed to say. His name is Jonathan. He's been living back there for 8 months.
Living back where? Back in the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a camp there.
Interrogating?
They talked to him when I was standing there, and that was basically it. I tried to buy him some food. He wanted cigarettes. He said he had food to beat out of the dumpster every morning. And
so cigarettes were more important. I get it.
I said, well, let me get you a pack of your drink, or do you want some cigarettes? Like, if you want a soda pop? He's like, I haven't had a good Newport in how many years. And I went and bought him 2 packs of Newports. And I said, when I come back out this way, I will cook you a home-cooked meal. And I said, I'll bring it every time that I come out here. And then I noticed yesterday, he's not there. He's scared. But Jonathan did give me his number. And he did tell me that his mom lived on Carmel Avenue, that the stepfather did not like him. He's a 43-year-old man. His mother was diagnosed with cancer, and the guy made him leave. That's why he does not have a place to live.
So he lives near his mom.
Yeah, so he stays right here around the corner from Carmel.
Do you think we should call the police for those clothes?
I think we should demand them.
I mean, they didn't even take the rope, for God's sake. So my kid told me,
what did
my sister doesn't even know that. I didn't know they didn't take it out.
What did you find here prior? You said you found other articles, and they did take them.
She, yes. She had on a black shirt, like jacket, and I hated the thing. I used to tell her all the time, Kat would wear it. It looks like a douche. It's got little pockets on the inside, and it has like a seam that comes down here. The night that she was last seen in videos, that's what she had on. They said black jeans. Kat did not wear black jeans. She didn't wear no tight. Very rare did you see her in blue jeans, and when she did, she never wore black.
Mm-hmm.
She wore those little city trim black dress, super thin flats.
Yeah.
She was really tall. She was almost 6 foot tall.
Yeah.
She was not 5 foot seven. She didn't weigh 180 pounds. She weighed 120 pounds.
So she was very slender and
she
tall.
She had a miscarriage, and they had
was the
iron filled. She lost so much blood.
The miscarriage was with Colin?
Yes. This was not the first one. This was the second one.
How did his parents not know about her?
Let me ask some about Colin. So has Colin called you since this happened?
Michael Deegan called me and said, hey, do you know what's going on? And I said, what are you talking about? He said, Kathleen is missing. And I said, I don't know what you're talking about. She was just here Thursday for Thanksgiving. And he's like, you need to call and find out what's going on. He was out of town.
And who's Michael Deegan?
Michael Deegan is like a father figure to her daughter, Steph. We call her Cannoli. It's her little nickname. Mm-hmm. I gave her when she was born. Her father, when she was born, was in a severe accident. He wasn't total brain dead, but they kept him alive on machines.
Mm-hmm.
He's just always been a father figure to her. And he is probably one of Kat's dearest. He is her best male friend, I can tell you that. Because I think he was in love with her for years.
Yeah.
For years.
But Colin never talked to you.
He called me after Deegan called me because I called Colin's job. I didn't have a number on him.
That was the Kobe's?
No, I called Harold Seltzer's where he worked.
Oh, Harold Seltzer's in Newport Richard.
Yeah. And I had gave his boss my number and told him that my daughter was missing, that I needed to speak with him. Could you give him my number and have him call me? And I asked him when he did call, I said, what is going on? Where is Kat? And he's like, I don't know. He said, she left here. And I'm like, what do you mean she left here? And he said, we got in a really big argument. We were drinking a lot. We were both drunk. And she got pissed, got her phone, and said, I'm calling. I'm out of here. And I know Kat, that's her. Like, she's that type of person. And
have you heard?
When she left, did you see who she left with? And he said, no. I said, what do you mean? You didn't get up to see who she got in a car with? He said, honestly, no. And he's like, I should have never let her leave drunk to start with.
What time was that?
It was after 1. When I talked to him or when she left, it was after like 1 a.m. in the morning.
Was anyone else in the house with them?
I was told there was another gentleman that was in the background when she had video chat with somebody, that Colin to her was not alone. There was another man there.
Well, I'll try to find him.
I sure don't.
Do you know if it was his roommate? Do you know what his roommate looks like?
No, and I didn't even know Colin had a roommate. It's like every day I just keep getting more pieces to this puzzle.
Has Colin been abusive to her in the past that you know about?
I've never seen him hit her. She had 2 miscarriages, and the day before Thanksgiving, when she come over to help me cut like the vegetables and the walnuts and the cranberries up, she sat down because there was so much stuff that needed dicing. She had a bruise, I told the cop, on the top of her left side of her head. It was up here. She had a really high peaking forehead. And I said, what did you do to your head? And she's like, what are you talking about, Mom? And I said, you have a big old bruise on your head. And she's like, no, I don't. She put the knife down. She went to the bathroom. And she's like, I'm telling you, I don't have a bruise. It's just my head. And I said, Kat, you get a bruise like that 2 ways.
Yeah.
Either somebody's putting their hands on you, or you have fallen down drunk. She knows how we feel about the drinking, because we've really been doing tough love with her.
Yeah.
She was really doing great.
Right.
Yeah, so I don't want to say this uncomfortably, but I've noticed both of them had trouble in the past, you know, legally wise, but it seemed like she had her act together in the last couple of years.
Yeah.
It seems like, you know, she's working and trying to do better. I've noticed that. And regardless, no one's past to justify anything of what's been
what happened. The key here is to find out where she is, who's responsible.
Jess, they didn't even take the rose. No, they didn't. This lady has it.
Hi, guys. Thanks.
Hi, how are you?
That's my other daughter.
Yes, sir.
Were you on my live yesterday?
What would you like law enforcement?
Okay.
I'm trying to stay focused.
No, nobody has ever called me since the day I called. Not one.
Are you who went over there to the parents' house?
Did you have to wait 3 days with the missing person report from the time she was actually missing on the 29th for them to act, or did they act beforehand?
Actually, the girl, I think Jess and one of the other girlfriends had called. A bunch of kids were calling. They were very concerned. I know it's a 48-hour thing, but when someone don't show up for work and their school, and the phone was found and recorded, and it's like, I just felt like they didn't act. I know they're doing, they say they're doing everything, but it's like, are you really, what is your dog sniffing? Because
that doesn't look familiar to you at all, does it?
Yeah. The night she left, did she have a backpack with her or personal belongings?
She usually either had a bag or some type of bag, like a backpack, like I have.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. So
you found more clothes over there. Past the sheriffs came and got them? Detectives or just regular deputies?
Regular sheriffs.
But they left some other items.
Yeah, and I told Jeff, I said, I actually think another pair of them panties for her, because I do her laundry all the time, and when I didn't do it, I let her come.
These don't look familiar.
No.
Okay. I see a couple items I'm just going to ask you about. This is another. That looks like guys. Okay. So.
I saw you guys over in his neighborhood knocking on his door.
Yes.
And I saw her at the parents.
So yeah. You're keeping an eye on him.
I'm posting every, I'm something hopefully every night. I don't want to assume, but my mom probably never.
She looks like a fine young lady.
Do I think there's potential? Yes, because when I talked to him,
let's not give up.
Listen to him, there was no emotion in his voice. His story changed twice on me. He never told me that there was somebody else there.
Who was there? Was that the Escobar?
There's some guy that's a singer that's one of the girlfriend's boyfriends.
A singer.
He's a singer. I can really show you what he told me. He would give me. He has it because everyone's harassing him now. He's not communicating.
So we went up there today, got out. He was out there with his roommate Esteban.
Of course.
With the white SUV out there. Or the Hummer. So they were there.
I asked him to meet him.
Where's Kathleen?
She took.
What do you know, Connie? And he started beelining into his house. And he was like, so if you're innocent, just speak. Oh. And
it was one of the girls' boyfriends. Well, there was a witness who was there with you, Collin.
That's what Collin said?
Yeah.
So you've been communicating with Collin?
I was communicating with him.
That sounds to me like an excuse, because...
Because if you cared, you would tell what you know.
Period.
I do not know that.
People are saying that. What I do know is that he's still going
to work. Cadillac's there now. There's a black one. There's a black
one. Hello?
Yeah. His initial story was that when he told me was that they got in a fight. You know,
you're okay.
He took hurt words. When the cat gets mad, you can't stop her when she's talking. She's going to finish it. That there was no way of stopping her. So I just let her go. And after she left, that was it. That was the first story. The second story was, because I said, Collin, because I've been with my fiance for 6 years. If I get in a fight, at least he's going to look out the window, follow up or something.
Yeah.
Something. The next thing is, I was like, did you not look to see where she went? Well, when I looked out, there was a dark sedan. That drove by. Did you see her in the sedan? No, I don't know, but there was a dark sedan. I'm not 100% certain that it was black. I have that in my messages. And then that's when I found Chris Mathis. I had a message FaceTiming her when she got in a fight with him that night. And Chris is the one who said that he saw Colin and another guy in the van there. That she had already been waiting 3 minutes for her Uber to come and pick her up. But he doesn't know if she
We found a full syringe.
Did she actually call him?
Chris won't answer me. So I can't find out from him. Because again, Nikki's the one that's. I've gotten so many different stories from her too. That I don't know what is the truth. I'm mad with her right now for the fact that she has over 400 flyers and she's there and she hasn't brought them out here. They're doing a visual as if she's dead instead of in the area that she was not seen.
Exactly. Like
and
us.
You're drinking.
Like us. We've been going through that swamp. Back
yeah, we went through.
We can't only go so far because correct. Right from back of his house, there's actually a swamp.
Yeah.
So we went there. We went down that, what was that called? The roadway over there where the bridge is.
Celtic.
A neighbor very sympathetic to this. One of
there's
his
a bunch
neighbors.
Of them.
Now that took us and said, if you guys need to park here or you guys need anything, if you guys want to initiate a search, stand in front of this guy's home and put pressure on him, just talk, whatever. She's with us. She took us down over there. We got all kinds of stuff and we've been searching around, looking for it, looking for clothes.
I'm her sister. That's how she calls me. It's her sister. Juicy.
Oh, so you're not your biological sister?
No, my mom, okay. I met Kathleen at Indian Pond 20 years ago. I was known as the fastest girl in the apartment complex. She moved in like, no, I'm faster than you. We had a race around the apartments. We tied. Ever since then, we've been inseparable. No matter where she's moved, we've always found each other, no mm-hmm. matter where she's gone. She came home. She used to help me with my homework because I have ADHD, but back then I wasn't diagnosed with it, so she'd come and help me with my homework. She stayed with me. She lived with my mom when she was pregnant with Stephanie. All
right.
She's been off and on with my mom's house.
She brought her off for dinner one day, and the child came back every night after that.
Because she didn't have a good home. Mom
yeah.
I used to have no food and tell them where and tell them how to.
Do you guys want to continue to have hashtags?
Yes.
That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
I do. I want awareness, but I don't want people to be aware of this. Deceased. That's
right.
My key.
Okay, still alive.
Still alive because if you pick that she's dead, people give up and they stop searching. The detectives have no more pressure. They don't because you can't blame him until there's a body.
On that night of,
there's no
interview. Any 7-11?
But people will start giving up.
This is right here.
What I want out there is that she is. She matters. She is someone.
Sound?
She is someone's mother.
Any
someone's sister.
Right.
She's someone's granddaughter. She's seen
life.
Everyone.
Because, no offense, Gabby Pito, as soon as she went missing, she got all this coverage literally overnight.
I reached out to
WFLA, they wrote an article the same day. Spectrum, they told me they'd get back to me. I called them on Wednesday. They told me there wasn't enough of a story or detail there to do anything with it.
We did have Spectrum out there today. I did an interview with them.
They are.
Yeah.
Literally on Wednesday, after she had been reported, I reached back up and I don't have to pick and choose. There's not enough interest and enough detail. She's a missing person. Her phone's in a dumpster.
There's not going to be enough interest in it until you make enough interest in it.
Exactly. But because she doesn't fit.
Right.
Image.
And that's why we were out here, because that's what we were saying. You know, when we come out, we usually, you know, get a little loud. We bring people, you know, we create the news if need be.
Would you support us out front as out to saying, what do you know?
That's fine. Just don't accuse.
What do you know?
Colin, we're not accusing you. What do you know? You were the last one to see her.
Yeah.
Help us find her. We're not trying to harass you. We just want to bring Kathleen home. That's all her family wants. Speak up. Help us.
Yeah.
Because when you accuse, they close off.
She went to his parents.
I saw that. Which of the mothers? I can't understand.
She was very empathetic. She said she hadn't seen her son since that Sunday. She didn't even know about Kathleen, which is awfully hard for me to believe now that I know that she's been pregnant a couple times from him. Is it possible?
I've been with him 23 years, 5.5 years. I didn't know that they were dating.
Because people were telling us they really weren't dating. It was more of a sex thing.
You didn't
Yeah.
Because we have those conversations.
Right.
She was, for me, I feel like she kept going back to me. She wanted to do law. And he was stable. And asked her, maybe a job. She could provide in a way that her past boyfriends had not.
Gotcha.
Kathleen was looking for someone to grow with, to have a family, to nurture. Do I think that she loved him? She did love him. Was she in love with him? No, because that night of Thanksgiving, she was reminiscing about exes.
Yeah. Is it possible?
Here's what else, right? Try to help victims' families. We try to bring awareness. We try to ruffle feathers. We try to do everything to keep the spotlight on the situation. You know what I mean? Get in people's heads to try to find things. We did it with the Petito. There's a couple that was murdered in Moab. We just went out to this. I live here. This is my community, so I can vouch for you guys that I'll help. Now, in the next couple of days, next week, we're going up to Tennessee to help with the Summer Wells case. I don't know if you know about Summer Wells. Yeah, so your 5-year-old, she's missing, stuff like that. We made a commitment there. We will be back here. We will help any way we can. We'll come around, hand flowers, like you said, we'll do whatever.
I literally just got in my new position. I'm there from 7 a.m. to 7 a.m. I'm shipping and fulfillment supplies at a private pharmacy.
Right.
And I have no choice.
Yeah, a little seat right there. Decorate the house.
Because believe me, the last place
I got to go home and decorate the house.
Yeah.
I call so every morning.
Oh, no.
People, some people like criticize us and say, oh, we just do it with clout.
No.
It's not about that.
Clout is when you're having a visual and putting t-shirts of somebody, memorializing them before they've been found. That's looking for clout.
This is the work here. Finding answers.
Is having been toasting her before she's allowed. Being out here searching is what matters. Posting her pictures. Posting pictures of her. It's fine to have a picture or two of yourself, but they're pitting her face up. Because when you get pictures of how do they know who it is?
Yeah. I had the flyer up on my live last night. Sure flyer that was up on that post right across from Collin's house. Stayed up on there for 2 hours.
Juicy said that they had a toxic relationship. Yeah.
She had miscarriage twice, right?
Is it possible? Let me ask you this. Is it possible that she was pregnant again and they got in a fight over that?
When you miscarry, you're at a higher potential because your HCG levels do go up. Mm-hmm. So you are at a higher potential of becoming pregnant right after a miscarriage.
Collin,
was she pregnant? No, because she had been drinking.
Does he have children?
To my daughter.
No, he doesn't. Okay. She told me he did not want any.
Bye. Chelsea. We'll see you later. Yeah, we'll do. Take care. Thank you so much.
Communicating with somebody on a messenger, Pinky.
Pinky is Juicy versus Mickey's sister.
Yeah, so she's bringing us up to speed.
Again, she's another one that's looking for more.
Okay,
if you look at her social media, she's posting pictures of herself. Not Kathleen. She's looking for
goodness.
Yeah.
When I did, I didn't even want to be on video. They called me when I was at work. The BFLA. She's more, Jessica's giving the details. She's giving false information instead of let's focus on Kathleen.
Diane, do you want us to call for this stuff now?
We did yesterday.
No, but we can apply a different. We can tell them they need to take it. That this is ridiculous.
I don't know why they didn't take the road.
And would you like us to help you pass out flyers?
Yes, yes. I'm going to his neighborhood now.
I'll go with you.
Yeah.
I got permission from one of the guys.
Well, the question: do we want to come?
Permission too from another neighbor that lives at that.
And she lives on the block deck.
Okay, yeah, there was that, what was that woman's name that took us,
Kanya.
So a woman lives on the same street, she said we can park on her grass.
Huh?
A neighbor helping.
Yeah, well, Kanya was a neighbor, too. She's told us, she took us for a walk down the Celtic, and we went kind of into the woods and stuff like that. We went out there early this morning, and, you know, we went and we didn't even realize that road was the road that had the motorcycle club on it. But we went out there in the woods and we just got as far as we could go. And the rest of it was just swamp. But see, this is my, it sounds horrible, but, and I understand what they're trying to say. But, you know, I need to find places that people will be to tuck things away. And I'm just thinking, it looks like somebody could come down here. And there's a drainage pipe, a big old drainage pipe. Has anybody been in there to check it? Hey, Jonathan, I think I want to go down here and check.
Can you access it from this side?
I think it'll probably be easier for me to get it from this side.
From this side?
Yeah, I really do, because I looked at it from down there, because this looks like it's almost a stepping. Yep. Ouch. Oh, maybe it is down further. Maybe I needed to go down further. Hold on. I think I needed to go down further. Yep. I went the wrong way. I saw it, but I couldn't remember where I saw it at. Probably a little too steep for a big old man. And you're sitting here on 54 and
Seven Springs. That's the Walgreens there that where her cell phone was found in the dumpster.
Right.
We were trying to call the man. Man person was with on the 29th of November, two blocks that way.
Yeah.
So we were down on the Angelo River there earlier, going along the river. Look, I got prickers all over me. So we're just out there trying to bring awareness, trying to keep her name in the spotlight. Somebody knows something. That's fine. Have me to bring her home to her family.
So we were out here with the mom. And here are some of the women's underwear and clothing that law enforcement didn't find the need to take. So I will be collecting it. This is open. This is also where we found the rope, the rope for the hand ties. And we are going to keep looking for evidence. I'm highly disappointed in law enforcement. That's all I can say is I'm highly disappointed in law enforcement. So, Kathleen Moore's mom is up there at Collin's house knocking his door, her and her sister. So the mother and the sister were able to get inside. because I was parking the car, so I didn't get in trouble with law enforcement for being on the road. I think the 7-Eleven would probably have better surveillance.
He says 7-Eleven wants her store to get her smoke, so that was the store she went to for all her crap. I guarantee you, she walked out of here, and I know Kat. She, first thing she went got
was cigarettes.
Oh, yeah, she wasn't even supposed to be smoking like me.
All right, love. Well, you guys, I've got to go take a shower. I've been up since 4 o'clock. Oh, let me give you a hug, honey. And we're going to continue to search, and we'll be back. We'll be back.
I'm going to go inside the waterway.
Okay. Yeah, I know. So I got your mom's number. If I got your mom's number, have her give it to you, and you call me anytime. All right? Love you guys. Take care.
You're coming.